Ladies and gentlemen, we're ready to start the we're close to ready to start the Shackleton. She's been a bit cantankerous the last few days, so we're hoping everything goes well. Not surprising, she's 60 years old this year, so we expect a little bit of age-related problems. So we will be starting number in the sequence 3421. So when you look at the aeroplane, that is the left-hand wing inboard engine, and then outboard engine, and then across to number two, which is the inboard one on the other side, and so on. This aeroplane is arrived here in about 1988 in pieces, and I'd like to say it's fully put back together, but it isn't. The last two or few bolts we find are missing every now and again. So we have, this is a six engine aeroplane. It got very heavy in its later days.
It was decided
to put a couple of jets outboard. The jet engines are not actually in the aeroplane at the moment, but they are in the museum. It's possible in future we will actually fit the jets. Oddly enough, the jets actually run on the wrong fuel. They don't run on jet fuel. They actually run on the avgas, which is a petrol-based fuel, which is the normal fuel in the aeroplane. Once we get ready to start, we use the ground power set in front of the aeroplane to generate 28 volts to give us lots of current. The engines take about 250 amps on startup, run to go down to about 100 amps when they turn. So we're hoping with a bit of luck that they'll start fairly quickly. We need to get fuel to the front of the engine to do that. We've suffered in the past where the fuel lines get a lot of air inside them, and they can be a so-and-so to start. We also have radiator problems with each one of these engines because they're, again, the radiators are over 60 years old. So it's quite likely that we will end up doing a shortage run on some of them, as they get hot, they may vent. So we'll have to see how we go. We've done a lot of radiator changes in the last few days, and we're hoping that
on a normal start, you normally have all the rad flaps set to auto, and it's got like an inching control unit on it which looks at the temperature from the right-hand radiator, and it would inch the flaps open as it warms up. And they used to work on this, but they rely on Bowden cables for feedback, which fill up with water and seize, so that's that out the window straight away. But Pete did a really clever bit of electronics in one, and it measures the temperature and then feeds back, and it works. It does work, but we got no nitrogen in it today, so we're going to hope to God that the red flaps don't shut on us, because otherwise it's going to be fairly short.
I can hear you.
Yeah. Right, are we ready? 29. I think we can make progress. So,
beacons are on.
Lightmaster and all the rest of it.
Yep.
Nav lights.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to put the fuel pump on to number 3. Engine start master switch is on. Priming to 3. You have 3 fuel cock open and 3 mags, please.
Fuel cock open.
Mags on 3.
Right. Wish us luck. Priming and turning.
Open.
then hot.
Fuel cock's all closed.
Shall we have a go? Start and see if we can start number one with it. I'm back again. Shall we have a go? See if we can get number one to go.
Oh, they're all clapping and everything. I wouldn't.
I'd leave it at that.
I'd leave it.
A duty on the starter, isn't it? And giving number two starter.
Yeah, okay. Well, a bit short than, what was that? 8 minutes.
Right.
Righto. Signing off.
Well done, guys.
Right, brakes released.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, she's played a little bit of a game with us. That gives us something to do over the next few days. But we'd like to say thank you very much for coming out today. Without your help and assistance, we won't be able to do this, and some of our heritage would disappear into the dust. So for Gatwick Aviation Museum, all the people, the trustees, the manager, and all the volunteers here, we'd like to say a very great thank you for helping us and supporting us today. Thank you very much. Good.